Hello friends, my name is Vasim and I welcome you all to this channel Bank for You. So friends, in this video I will be discussing the simplification questions which were asked in IBPS CLERK prelims exam 2018, and these are the memory based questions which I have taken here just because to understand what sort of questions you may get in the upcoming exam of IBPS CLERK. So friends, once you come across the question, try to solve the questions by yourself and continue watching the video. And one more thing is that, so you have to put pen and paper to solve these kind of questions because it is quite easy questions. So simply you have to remember few things and you have to solve the questions accordingly. Okay. So let's try to do it friends. As you can see, the first question here is x square plus 9 square plus 34 divided by 5 is equal to 39. So see here, whenever we confront the questions of simplification and approximation, we have to solve those questions based on the method of BODMAS. So BODMAS means, B means the brackets. That means whatever there is within the brackets that has to be simplified. O is nothing but of, that is nothing but multiplication. D, division. Then your multiplication, E, addition. Then S, subtraction. So see here, x square we are going to take as it is, x square plus 9 square, we know it is 81 plus 34. So 9 square, 81 plus 34 is 85 plus 30. That's like 115. 115 divided by 5. 115 divided by 5 is like 5 1 time, 5 2 time it is 10, 15 is carried forward, 3 times it is 15. So it's like 23. So this is plus 23. If I'm going to transfer this plus 20 to the other side, that becomes minus 23. That is like x square is equal to 39 minus 23. So x square is equal to 39 minus 23. 9 minus 3 is equal to 6. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So because if you are going to transfer that power square to the other side, that becomes x is equal to square root of 16. That's like 4 is the answer. So see here, you have to put all these steps here. Okay. Simply x square is equal to 39 minus 23, we know it's 16. So square root of 16, we know it's 4. So you have to put all this. You simply can solve the question, right? Let's check out the next one here. 6 into 16 into 5 divided by 3 minus x square is equal to 96. So see here, I need not to put this, but just for your sake, I'm going to write it over here again. 6 into 16 into 5 divided by 3 can be taken as in this way. So therefore, 3 1 time, 3 2 times, right? So 5 into 16 is 80, 80 into 2 is 160. 160 take as it is, bring this 96 to this side, this becomes minus 96 is equal to, if we transfer this minus x square to the other side, that becomes plus x square. So it is like 60, that is 160 minus 96 is 4 plus 60, that is 64. X square is equal to 64. If I transfer this power to the other side, this becomes square root of 64. X is equal to 8 is the answer. So simple one. Let's check out the third one here. Square root of 124 plus x plus 169 is equal to 18. See here friends, so whenever we come across these kind of questions, just apply square on both the sides. So it's like this. Okay. So see here, this square value and this square root value gets cancelled here. So the remainder would be 124 plus x plus 169 is equal to 18 square. We know it is 324. So add these two values. 100 plus 169 is 269. 269 plus 1 is 270. 270 plus 23, because I have taken only 1 here. 270 plus 23 is 293. So x is equal to, if I am going to transfer that 293 to the other side, this becomes minus 293. It's like 24 plus 7 is equal to, so 31 is the answer here. X is equal to 31 is the answer. Let's check out the next one here. 28 square minus x cube is equal to 7 cube plus 325. So we know 7 cube, it is 343, plus this can be taken as 225, right? So is equal to x cube as it is. So 28 square, 28 square we know it is 784. So this is like 784 minus x cube is equal to 343 plus 225. Okay. So see here friends, if I am going to transfer this minus x cube to the other side, that becomes plus x cube. Okay, this is like plus x cube. So let us add these two values together. So 300 and 200 is equal to 500. 40 plus 20 is equal to 60. 560. 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. 568. So if I transfer this plus 568 to the other side, that becomes minus 568. Okay. So this is like minus 568 is equal to what? X cube. Sorry again. So it's like, sorry for this. So it's, 784 minus 568 is equal to x cube. So x cube is equal to, so 14 minus 8 is equal to 6. So 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. So 7 minus 5 is equal to 2. So if I transfer this cube to the other side, that becomes cube root of 216. So x is equal to, we know, 6 cube is equal to 216. So x is equal to 6 here is the answer. Let's go to the next one here. So 298 minus 13 square. So minus 2 cube is equal to x into 11. So 298 we can take it as it is. Okay. Minus 13 square, we know this can be taken as 169. 2 cube can be taken as 8 here. 169 and 8 has minus sign here. So therefore that can be added. So 169 minus 8 is equal to, so minus 169 minus 8 is equal to 177. So minus 177 is equal to x into 11. So x is equal to, see here, 298. 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. So 9 minus 7 is equal to 2. And 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So if I am going to transfer this 11, which is in the numerator, to the other side, that will be going to the denominator. So therefore x is equal to 121 divided by 11. 11 1 time, 11 11 times. So therefore x is equal to 11 is the answer. But then see here friends, I am just explaining you, that is why I am just doing all these steps. But you have to do this, all these steps in the exam. So just simply take all the values into your mind and just solve it. Okay, let's check out the next one here. So cube root of 729 plus 3 by 5 divided by x is equal to square root of 16 into 9. So 16 into 9, we know it is 144. If we take this 144 to the out of the root, this becomes 12. Okay. So cube root of 729 can be taken as 9 here. So if I transfer this plus 9 to the other side, that becomes minus 9 on the other right hand side. So 12 minus 9 is equal to 3. So therefore 3 by 5 can be taken as, so 5 3 is a 15, 15 plus 3 is equal to 18 divided by 5 divided by x. So divided by x is, so 18 divided by 5 into x is equal to 3. Okay. So if I transfer this x to the other side, that will be going to the numerator. So 18 divided by 5 is equal to 3x. If I transfer this 3 to the other side, that will be going to the denominator. So therefore 5 into 3. So 5 into 3, we know it is 15. Okay. 18 divided by 15 is equal to x. X is equal to 15 one time. So 15 one time, it is 15. Okay. So remainder is 3 here. So 15, see, if I am going to put a 0 here, I will be putting a point here. 15 into 2 times, it is 30. So therefore, x is equal to 1.2 here. Let's go to the next one here. So x percentage of 300 plus square root of 256 is equal to 243 divided by 3 plus 7. So x percentage of 300 can be taken as x by 100 into 300. So therefore, two zeros gets cancelled. This can directly be taken as 3x plus, so square root of 256, we know it is 16. Okay, we know it is 16. So 243 divided by 3. So 3 1 time, 3 8 time, 3 1 time. So 81. 81 plus 7 is 88. Okay, so 81 plus 7 is equal to 88. So 88, if I transfer this 16 to the other side, that becomes minus 16. So 88 minus 16. So 88 minus 16. Okay. So 3x is equal to 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. So 3 1 time. So 3 2 time it is 16. 1 is carried forward. So 3 4 times it is 12. Okay. So therefore x is equal to 24 is the answer. Here is the next question. X into 3 by 8 x into 3 by 8 is equal to cube root of 512 into square root of 12 square. Okay. So, see here. So, x into 3 by 8 can be taken as x into 3 divided by 8 is equal to square root of 512 can be taken as 8 here into, so see here 12 square we know 144. If we take this out of the root, so this can be taken as 12 itself. So therefore, this power and square root get cancelled. So 8 into 12. Okay. So 8 into 12, we know it is 96. Okay. If I transfer this 3 by 8 to the other side, the reciprocal has to be taken. That is 8 divided by 3. 3 1 time, 3 3 times, 3 2 times. Okay. X is equal to 8 2 is 16. 1 is carried forward. 8 3 is 24. 24 plus 1 is 25. So therefore, x is equal to 256 is the answer here. Here's the next question. 136 divided by 2 square into x is equal to 17% of 500 divided by 10. Okay. So see here. So 136 divided by 2 square is nothing but 4. So 4 1 time, 4 3 times it is 12. 1 is carried forward. 4 4 times it is 16. So therefore, the simplification of this is equal to 34x. 34x is equal to 17% of 500 can be taken as, see here, so this percentage and these two zeros is cancelled anyway. Okay, 17 into 5, we know it is 8.5. So, sorry, 85. 17 into 5 is 85. 85 divided by 10 is 8.5. Okay, so 8.5. So, if I transfer this 34 to the other side, that will be going to the denominator. Okay, so 8.5 into 2 times it is 17, 8.5 into 4 times it is 34. So therefore, this is like 1 time, this is 4 times. So x is equal to 1 by 4, that is like 0.25 is the answer here. So here is the last question. You just try to solve this question by yourself and let me know the answer in the comments below. So this is all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day ahead. So before ending up this session, I request you to subscribe to our channel, like the video, share the video with your friends, and if you have any doubts, please let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day ahead.